The shooting spree began shortly after 7, as about 100 postal employees were sorting their daily mail. The suspect, part-time postal employee Pat Sherrill, calmly walked up to his supervisor and opened fire. He was armed with 3 pistols. Postal employees said he walked almost calmly through the sorting room, reloading and firing the .45, 9mm, and .22 caliber weapon.
He shot 2 people, then he just turned around and started spraying the room. And how my brother-in-law got away from it, I'll never know, because he was right there at the corner. He should have been one of them too, but I don't know how. I looked underneath there to see if his feet were there, and then I dove across the way underneath a bunch of cases.
They are individuals feeling this crisis together as a community. Some had friends, family who died, but others felt the pain from afar, strangers sharing a common grief.
Give me more papers!
Across the city, that grief was first an insatiable need to know more about the killings, to say it couldn't happen here, then an anger to ask what no one can answer. Why did it happen?
I think it's very normal and natural for us all to feel victimized on these occasions that a tragedy like this occurs. The Edmond community's had more than its share of victimizations in the last few months, from murders to tornadoes to a mass murder like this.
People drawing together to talk about it, pray about it, and listen to each other is the doctor's best advice. As one mourner put it, try to make sense of the senseless. From Edmond, Jane Braden, 5 Alive News.
Letter carrier Ron Blackwell had to cross the yellow police markers surrounding the Edmond post office before he could begin delivering the mail today. A survivor of the Wednesday massacre, Blackwell made a conscious decision to keep going. He said he knew he had to go back to work.
It was an eventuality, so today's as good a day as any.
Blackwell walks an 8-mile route, which includes the downtown Edmond business community. Merchants here are just blocks away from the murder scene.
Everybody in this building certainly was grateful that you weren't physically hurt. I know that's not enough. They cared.
Greetings like this one followed Blackwell throughout the day. They helped to ease the pain.
It's glad to see all these people, I tell you. What happened? Praise the Lord.
Hey, young fella. We're ready to see you.
Real good.
Barber Slim Yandell said he feared he'd never see Blackwell again. From the hugs to the symbolic yellow ribbons, the message was clear. The community cares.
Yes, I know you know.
While Ron Blackwell is back on the job, it is not business as usual. And Blackwell says it may never be. Holly Eccles, 5 Alive News in Edmond.